Welcome back to Evil Deedz, episode 14 of Fist of the North. Fist of the North Stars, Ken's Race 2. And we will end this little game, or long game, whatever.
その男の名はバット。お前が探している男ではない。その貴志郎か。そう。貴様が誰だか知らんが、その男は返してもらうぞ。変な野郎、人の目を潰しておいて許せねえぞ。
さすがは本物の剣士の
Fight the hologram of yourself. What you saw me at the very first thing. Very first video.
とっとと決めてくれ。
バッタ、変わらないの？
死は背には慣れません。私はバットのそばから離れません。一生バットのお墓のそばにいてあげたい。そうでしょう、ケン。行くがいい。俺の心はいつもお前のそばにいる。ケン、さよなら。
すでに死んでいる。
Like I said in episode 1, I wouldn't recommend this game. Okay, it gets boring. And it gets boring quickly. The story's mode is like based on the manga, so it's like more focused on that than the actual gameplay itself. It's like the gameplay came after and it just filled in the gaps. And then with Dream Mode, it's like a different team worked on that part of the game. Because they focused on a bit of both. They didn't prioritize one over the other. So you got Dolby Digital. So that is the end of all the. So at the moment, on Dream Mode, I've done all them story modes, therefore I thought it was going to change the background instead of having lines on it and a blank screen, but nope, it didn't. So in Dream Mode, I will do the events for it. But I will start from, in the videos I will start from Ken, and to the right, then bottom, to the right, and so on. So if you want to demand a playthrough of it, you're doing the stages, you have more time demanding a last place, but it do take a while to complete. So far, that's the All Them Brothers. I haven't done any of them stages yet, the grey ones. But with this stage here, I have to do it 6 times. It's the same stage, but just different people. And then the challenge mod does it in Rapper Story. So I'll probably play that first, just to give it time to demand playthroughs of people, or characters, who you want me to be. and Lone Warriors. So Lone Warrior stories, the people want to jump into the stories in between the other people's stories. So they just jump into any random battle, to be honest. I don't know about these, I haven't played any. So them two go together for all them stages, nearly. And this guy goes on that top line. Yep. Rings and bats, it goes, it crisscrosses. And then they end the same way. These don't have any story mode, and you unlock heart if you do all the challenge mode, or if you beat Outlaw for a while. Depends, I don't know how you unlock him, but that's how I unlocked him in the first place. So, I see, does that have a story either? Where you can play as them in free mode. So, hope you enjoyed the video. Please do like, subscribe, or comment down below if you want to, so you don't have to. I'm going to do a level. Let's do it. Challenge. Challenge mode. The Wasteland Folk. So this is the map. This is to show you what the dream mode's like. So I'm by myself for this one. They're the bases. The higher the level, the more points you get. And if you get over a certain amount of points, you get an A rank at the end. So you always go for the highest one, like that level 7. And then level 6. But I can go for that level 1, then the level 7. Level 6, and them to a level 3, so that level 4 is going to turn to a level 3 if you take over that 7. Basically, if you take over that first one at the top right, it makes that middle level 3 go down to 2 after I capture it. Okay, it's got a line to it, it's linked, so it makes it weaker, the base. Play it in for signature moves. That's his strongest attack. Scrolls, yeah. Not great, but better dudes. This guy is actually kind of good. Is better than some. Let's ride the back. It's a bit faster than running, but still a bit slow. Oh, and the tennis table. It's like playing game. Tony Hawk's Underground. Skating game. Where you have to drive cars. Defeat we in time. As you see, I got an A on the right hand side. So that's 900 points. How far is it? Okay, well, Let me ride it. Never used this move before. Even chucks the bat. So let's go for this number 7. It looks like it's unblockable. Okay, let's go to that level 6. And as you can see, that level 3 base has turned to a level 1 now on the map. I took them 2 bases over, what will link to it. This is how you get your health back up with this character. He uses special move and he gains health. Then he makes a clone of himself and then he chucks knives between them. Use your head. Chucks his hair. Thank you. The only worst part about this character is that he's slow in his attacks. And that is the only downfall to this character. Get thrown forward. I don't need to get an A rank on this level anyway, I already got it. So let's do it. Before I run out of time. On the next stage, I will be versing a big, tall guy. That very tall guy, what Ken faced in the story. So where to next? Top one. You only need to capture 5 bases on this one as well. So you can't capture more than 5 bases. And when you do capture 5 bases, all the other bases that you haven't captured to captured, if you know what I mean. So it hits them 2 times. Now I'm versing myself. Yeah, they have invincibility frames, so you can't hit them whilst they're stuck in the animation. right himself. Yeah. So now I need to capture his boots. Gotta defeat a defense captain. Cut like a knife. Donuts. Here we go. Guessing that's not open yet. This race should be the fastest. You can't do wheelies on this game. It's quite enough. I can see the chest there. Roll. We are facing Hart, the one that sucks the punches in. That one of the first boss you faced on the story mode. Get the knife. You were charging. Very well, boom. Now we need to head back up to the top of the map. And we have got an air. Most of the time you're fighting on your own. But then there's sometimes where you're fighting with other NPCs, like other characters. Like when you saw that one with the six people on that stage, they're all on that stage at once. But you always in that same spawn point where you're spawning. We are getting shit. That took a lot of health. Let's just beat him with 2 specials. Boom. Boom. One more. And now he's done. Now put him blocking. Boom. Slash for them arms. 1,000. So the chosen ones. As you can see, the clear sign was a silver. So I got a B rank on this and not an A rank. So I will need to plan which base to go to, which is the best route. So the main boss guy is at the top. So we will go to the 4, the 5. The 6 and then the 3. Maybe I just go for that 5, 4, 2. Then 6, then 3. So number 4 first. This time I don't have a motor back on the stage. It's only a little corner. These troops are that commanders. The captain or whatnot. No, the soldier. I know I won't be able to finish all this level off, but there is a Intrium save, whatever you call it, a quick save, so I can continue from the point where I saved it. So that base is captured, and I can see it spawns in the troops that will help me now, but they don't do much, that's the only problem. Both sides need to do more in the troops part, because their troops don't even invade your bases, so they don't even try and take it over. So you don't have that back and forth kind of thing, where you have to protect the base whilst going after another one. Yeah. so it makes it a lot easier. A cakewalk. I didn't even plan to take that over, to be honest. But I'm going to leave that. There you go. Got an A on that base. So I'll leave the troops for that. To take down 4 people. Shouldn't take them that long. Oh, shouldn't do. So that will give me enough time to take this base over. One, two, three. Three hits, and they will die. Commando! Get the knife. Pardon? They even hit it. There it is. Nope. That time definitely got it. See, I still haven't took that level 1 base over yet. It had 4 people left. So I'm going to end it here before the video cuts off, so hope you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, subscribe or comment down below if you want to, it's up to you, don't have to. And in a bit.